Hi, welcome to Farmers End on the Road. Join us as we travel around the country and meet some amazing natural and organic farmers. Hear their stories, see their farms in some of the most stunning locations. Today we're meeting Seshu from Hampi Organics. He's a software engineer in Bangalore who manages his two mango and chiku farms in Hampi on the weekends. We met up with him at Ballari railway station and had a chat with him as we drove to the farm.
When we grew up, nobody used to tell us like you be a farmer. You just go and my parents used to tell, there's nothing here. You just have to study and go out and do something. Don't be here. That's what my parents used to tell. I mean, at a personal level, I also go and work in the farms along with the laborers or whatever work is. Just get involved into everything, every minute thing. What happened was, we're curious about this without any chemicals. How can things work? I mean, like, with that we started with the Palekar books and all, right? We just explored different options and went through all the books like properly, like underlined kind of thing, and every sentence was so interesting.
Subhash Palekar is an Indian agriculturist who developed and promoted a form of agriculture initially called zero-budget natural farming. Inspired by the techniques of famed Japanese agriculturist Masanobu Fukuoka, he developed a similar technique for Indian farmers. He developed the system in the mid-1990s as an alternative to the Green Revolution's methods driven by chemical fertilizers and pesticides and intensive irrigation. Fluent in many languages, Palekar has travelled far and wide in India, conducting farmer workshops and educating them about the merits of natural farming over chemical-based farming, encouraging farmers to reduce their input costs like fertilizers and pesticides. Zero-budget natural farming instead relies on farm-made concoctions designed to fertilize the soil and repel pests naturally. While the scientific community may not have reached a consensus on how the practice affects agricultural output, this is largely due to the lack of data and conclusive scientific research, though efforts are on to validate this method at various institutions around the country. On the ground though, farmers have been flocking to the concept, which is promoted heavily by both central and state governments.
When we went through it, it was like people in my family itself did not believe me. So my mother, my brother and all, like, even the guy who was working for me also, he didn't believe me. What? He's gone mad kind of. I mean, what is he talking about? Like, we made this concoction of 10 leaves. It's called Dashapani Kashaya. So when there were these worms or the pests on the sapota, I mean, we spread it and it never worked actually. I mean, next day we went and saw it was here and there, still there. But with the pesticide, they immediately fall off. So my guy was like saying, it won't work, sir, what are you doing, all this and all. But after a couple of days, all of them went off. These all kashayas are just, they're just repellents, they don't kill it. So we got to know that, and I was, my guy like who was working, he kind of got confidence on this works. So that was like a turning point, like first turning point for us. We got like two, three trolleys of big mulch from different places and started fully covering our sapota plants. He told put Jeevamrita, we put Jeevamrita and I used to go and see, dig, like remove the hay and all, just see what was there, take pictures and how are the earthworms coming. And so like that we started experimenting in 2010 actually. Next to our farm, on the sapota farm, our sapotas were so sweet. It's the same variety my dad had got, and he had got the same variety. And the same climate, same watering, same temperatures, same amount of rainfall, I mean, same soil type. How does it taste well? I mean, this is like, strike me a lot. Everything we do, like lemon we do, whatever we do, it's so nice. The perishability is less, it doesn't perish so fast. The quality, the looks, the taste, and in, you know, nutrition and all, I mean, you read so many books, nutrition is more, they say. So, man, this is a real food actually. This is what is the original food, what nature has given.
Seshu's farm is on the outskirts of Ballari, the rice bowl of Karnataka. This relatively small farm is like a lush oasis in the midst of a sea of paddy.
That's one of the basic problem that is facing the current farming communities. They only depend on one crop, monocropping. So we have like at least 5 to 6 sources of income we wanted to develop in our farm. Already developed some of them. So we want to have a long-term strategy like that. And basically by this multi-layer farming, one is a bigger tree like a mango tree, and a smaller tree like a Mosambi tree, and the next level is a sitafal or a papaya, or each of these have these levels. So that way, I mean, one crop fails, we have the other one that's backing up us.
Apart from being an ecologically sustainable approach to agriculture, this practice renders farms breathtakingly beautiful. In our experience in working with natural farmers, we have found that these farmers tend to have a deep connection with nature. Rather than working against it, they work with it and grow fantastic nutrient-rich produce.
You see, the nature is on the top. I mean, nature, we cannot overcome nature. That's the first thing we need to learn. When I started this cultivation, right, like my mom used to ask me, "Boss, you're not spraying anything. Will the flowering of the mango be on par?" I checked. There is a neighboring farm also, a couple of kilometers away. I went and checked there. See, on this day, this is my flowering. Without any chemicals, whatever Jivamruta and buttermilk we are spraying. And what is that guy doing? Let us compare the flowering. Both are same. On that year, based upon the climatic conditions, what is the flowering? You will get, you also will get. There is no chemical that is doing the flowering, boss. It's a nature that is doing, and a conducive climatic condition that are doing it. So that is I realized, boss, all this pesticide, all this growth enhancers, to some degree, but they don't solve your problem fully. I mean, so that's one of the learning.
Seshu's produce has been a super hit with farmers. He has a loyal fan base who scoop up his caramel-like chikus, the incredibly sweet and juicy mangoes, and the melon-like heirloom pumpkins.
Started, I think, in 2018 or 2019 with Farmizen, and I think we started with Support Us in March month sometime. It was a big hit. I mean, when we started, the moment we put the Support Us, this vanished like that. I mean, zoom. I mean, it was like a BSE Sensex rolling right like that. Farmizen is quite a different app. It's something like a farmer-centric, more focused on the farmer. Is what I believe, like the organization and the philosophy seems like that. So when we started, and really loved it when we started, it's something new that was there, a new experience for me. The logistics is always a challenge because we are a little bit far off from Bangalore. But having said that, we're trying our best to whenever there is a critical mass which will qualify for a shipment, we are doing it.
He receives the order from Farmizen pre-orders before the fruit is harvested. This way, he's able to plan his harvest precisely. By diversifying his crops, Seshu is able to supply some produce to customers throughout the year and hedge his bets on the success of each crop. Farmizen lists produce from hundreds of natural and organic farmers like Seshu. Download the Farmizen app and book your pre-orders now.